So these definitions we have with us regarding this chapter, solution thermodynamics. And you will see that there is a slight change in the chapter titles between two editions of the book. This is the 8th edition, and in 7th edition you will find it as a solution thermodynamics applications and theory and application. There are two chapters. So first thing, first we are on theory part. So we have now derived necessary relationships regarding binary mixture, and we have defined the partial molar property of the component, and we can calculate the total property of the solution in terms of partial molar property, or vice versa. Partial molar property can be calculated on the basis of the change in the total solution property. And the Gibbs-Duhem equation, I've emphasized last time. Let us look at this. Definition of the partial molar property is shown here, 10.7. So these things you should write. So this is a very general form. If suppose M is replaced by Gibbs energy G, then it will become chemical potential. Summability relation we learned, M equal to sigma xi mi bar. Mi bar means component I present in the mixture. So partial molar property of the component I, and what is the mole fraction of this component xi. So this kind of relationship is very common. Means you have ideal solutions, then you always have such type of situation. So this is summability means. And Gibbs-Duhem equation was derived last time. So what we observe in this Gibbs-Duhem equation, that if you write the total property, change in total property, dm, then you have these terms, d over m over d over p means with respect to pressure, and then with respect to temperature, and third term will be with respect to composition. So that composition term is not appearing here, and it is a means if you write dm in two ways, one is from mathematics, another is from summability relation. This, if you write dm, so it will become sigma xi dmi bar plus mi plus sigma mi bar dxi. So if you have written it earlier also, so let me show you here, it is there. So if you write it let me show you. See this, dm equal to sigma xi dmi bar plus sigma mi dxi. So this is one expression for dm, change in the solution molar property, and another is from mathematics. So what is that? This is here, 10.10. so if you equate these two things, then you have a cancellation of this last term, and then you have this change in pressure, change in temperature is equal to means sigma xi dmi bar. So here it is Gibbs-Duhem. So this is a way of remembering your Gibbs-Duhem equation. This is the term. So with respect to pressure, with respect to temperature, and then it is equal to sigma xi dmi. So always remember. So at constant temperature pressure, if you want to see the effect of only composition, then dp and dt do both become zero, then sigma xi dmi bar is equal to zero. This is most of the time a solution composition is changed keeping the temperature pressure constant. So this Gibbs-Duhem equation reduces to sigma xi dmi bar equal to zero. And if you apply for a binary solution composed of two chemical species, so we can write all these expressions. So these things you should practice. And related to this, you have already carried out the graphical interpretation, and example 10.2 you can practice. This is a very good example. And here also 10.3 and 10.2 and 3. So here this is the in terms of volume. So here it is again summability relation. If you write summability relation, then you can write all those things. So you just practice. 10.4 also you can practice. Last time I told you. So it is very interesting to solve this. This is simple mathematical form, and you can solve this expression also. So these are related to your earlier understanding. So just practice it. Now let us proceed further. Relations among partial properties. If you now, so far we have written in a general form. Now if you write this M property as a Gibbs energy, so partial molar property becomes partial molar Gibbs energy, and which is called a chemical potential. So mu I is equal to G I bar. So partial molar Gibbs energy is mu I, means component I having partial molar Gibbs energy, and it will be called its chemical potential. So this term is this particular quantity, this physical quantity is very much important, because it gives criteria for your phase equilibrium, criteria for chemical reaction equilibrium, and it is in terms of canonical variables, and it is one of the most important expressions, Gibbs energy. So this is your fundamental relation. You know dNg equal to nV dP minus NSdT plus sigma GiD. So this we have written for M equal to G, nothing else. Earlier we have written for in terms of general property M. Now we are writing in terms of Gibbs energy. So Gibbs energy, this fundamental relation for variable composition, already we have written. Now this, if you apply this a criteria of exactness to this and apply the Maxwell relation, then you can write this one. So this term is your if you write dz equal to m dx plus n dy, so you have this one. So dV over dT at constant pressure and composition gives you is equal to, so this Dever NV, Dever NV over Dever T, keeping this pressure and this composition constant equal to Dever NS, means change in entropy, means per unit change in pressure, keeping this temperature and composition constant. So now, so far we have applied this exactness criteria for two terms. Now we can apply it for three terms also. So here there are two subscripts, P and N here, and T and N. So in a similar way, we can write for three terms also the criteria of exactness. So mdx and ndy, dz equal to mdx plus ndy, then already I have told you the m means dever m over dever x keeping y constant, and then dever m over dever y keeping x constant equal to dever n over dever x keeping y constant. So this exactness criteria yields this one. So this is volume expressed in terms of entropy. So this entropy measurements can be written in terms of volume changes. So this is this can be written. So many expressions will appear. See, in thermodynamics we have a good application of mathematics. So equations are derived mostly from mathematical principles. So it is an exact science. This thermodynamics becomes exact science. So we need not to know many physics and chemistry about this. Only if we know small mathematics, then also we can derive many expressions. So here this is one example. Now here again, if you add the two additional equations, if you look at that, so this dever g I bar over dever p becomes equal to, so this equal to, and this. So how do you write this one? So this is one expression and this is another expression. So because see, this is your partial molar Gibbs energy, means if you differentiate it with respect to pressure, keeping the temperature and composition constant, then you have this one. So keeping pressure, temperature, and composition constant. And this, if you with differentiate with respect to temperature, then you have this second term, and so you can compare means. See, if you divide it by lever P, so what you look at this, see. So you have these two things constant, was then if you write with respect to this one, see, if you divide it with T, and then this becomes. So this also can be written from simple mathematics. Just look at that. So divide NS over divide NI means, so here, so Maxwell relations you can obtain from here. So you earlier also have done it, but now there are two parameters here. So you can practice that one. So these are all from there. So where the subscript N indicates constancy of Ni, therefore the composition and subscript Nj indicates that the all number of mole except Nth higher head constant. So whenever you vary compositions of component I, then other components are to be held constant in terms of composition. So that is shape. So this volume can be, partial molar volume can be expressed in terms of Gibbs energy. So this you should remember, partial molar volume in terms of Gibbs energy, and this partial molar entropy in terms of Gibbs energy again. So if you differentiate a partial molar Gibbs energy with respect to pressure, keeping temperature and composition constant, you have partial molar volume. So this is used in calculations. If you know the function of GI bar as a function of pressure, so you can differentiate it, keeping temperature and constant, so you get it. And this entropy can also be calculated in terms of K.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, partial molar volume से मतलब क्या है? मतलब इस volume में क्या होगा sir?
This is the volume of a component, given component. Suppose we have component I here. There are number of components in the solution. So I, J, K, L, M, N, O, many components may be present. So for component I, if we talk about partial molar volume of component I, that means the volume of one mole of the component I inside the mixture.
Okay.
Similarly, this entropy also. So this is the property of the component present in the mixture. It is, this component I is not in pure form. It is in mixture form. It is in solution where the other components are also present. Suppose you have 1 liter of water and 1 liter of methanol. Now, if you add 1 liter of water with 1 liter of methanol, then this 1 liter of water will not be occupying 1 liter volume inside the solution. It may be 999. So 1 ml will be less or higher. So that will be called partial molar, means if you talk about 1 mole of the substance, then it becomes partial molar property, partial molar volume. Similarly, if you talk about volume, then it is partial molar volume. If you talk about Gibbs energy or enthalpy or entropy, so partial means when the component is present inside the mixture. This partial is summing up and making total. Partial sum of partial properties makes total property. So that is the summability relation. Means total solution property for 1 mole will be given as sigma xi mi bar. Means their amount must be considered. So partial molar property weighted by their amount. So if you sum it up, so this is a very simple summability relation. it is always applicable for ideal solutions, and here also for non-ideal solutions is always it is applicable. But you will see that how this summability relation changes for entropy and Gibbs energy, for volume, enthalpy and internal energy. This is very straightforward, but in case of Gibbs energy and entropy, we'll see that for ideal gas mixture they take different forms. We'll see soon. So that means we should be able to write this partial molar volume in terms of Gibbs energy and entropy in terms of Gibbs energy. So this all follows from earlier discussions. You just practice these expressions, you will learn. Okay, so let us proceed. It is emphasizing here that every equation that provides a linear relation among thermodynamic properties of a constant composition solution has at its counterpart an equation connecting the corresponding partial properties of each species in the solution. What it means? So there is some linear relation among thermodynamic properties of constant composition. See here, this is constant composition. Okay, so means this every equation has its counterpart. Means we can calculate one property, and then we can also calculate another one if you differentiate with respect to some other variable. So here, if you differentiate Gibbs energy with respect to pressure, you get volume, and if you differentiate with respect to temperature, you get entropy, this partial molar entropy. So these properties of component I. Okay, so partial molar means we must know what is the function of this GI bar with respect to P, and here with respect to T. So here compositions are being held constant. So this is this follows all from earlier discussion. Now, for example, here it says that an example is based on the equation that defines enthalpy. So enthalpy, if you write enthalpy, you already know this expression for enthalpy, H equal to U plus PV. So for n number of moles, you have NH equal to NU plus P into N into V. Now, if you differentiate it, see, suppose you differentiate this. So you want to know the change in the total enthalpy of the solution per unit change in the component, change in moles of I. So you know that this will become partial molar enthalpy, keeping temperature, pressure and other components constant. So this is nothing but partial molar enthalpy of component I. Now, if you differentiate it, looking at this equation, what do you get? See, dev over nu over dev over ni and this. So here, see this. So what it becomes? It again becomes partial molar internal energy, and what it becomes? Partial molar volume. So means partial properties are also following the same rule. See, this is the property. It's a general means pure form property. Now partial property is also following in the same way. So when we write H equal to U plus PV, then we have, so that's why it is saying that is a linear relation has a constant composition solution has its counterpart. Means H equal to U plus PV, then you can write H bar equal to U bar plus PV bar. For component I, we can write in a analogous fashion, HI bar equal to UI bar plus PI bar. So there is no difference in the style of the expression. Total property or component means it pure form property, and the partial molar property, both can be written in the similar way, means with the same kind of expression. And you will see further when we proceed, residual properties can also be written in the same fashion, because it is a difference between real property and ideal gas property. So that also will follow. So which is a partial property analog, means 2.10, this equation which we earlier learned, 2.10 equation where the enthalpy was defined. So this is a partial property analog, means analogous equation which has been written for the partial property. Fine. So this is very simple, means just an example. Now here in a constant composition, GI bar is a function of temperature and pressure, so we can write. So GI bar equal to D. So it is a, suppose you express this GI bar as a function of temperature and pressure. If you take it means mathematical expression means GI as a function of T and P, then from total property change you can write dever GI bar dever T P into X dT plus dever GI bar over dever TX. So this is a function of two variable T and P, and we can write from mathematics. So simply dg bar becomes this is nothing but partial molar entropy, and this becomes partial molar volume. So you should remember this this particular expression, that partial molar gives energy when differentiated with respect to temperature, and keeping pressure and composition constant gives you partial molar entropy, and this gives you partial molar volume that we have already seen here. See this one, 10.18 and 10.19. G equal to dg, dg equal to vdp minus sdt, if you write. So dg, similarly dg bar equal to, see, look at this, dg vdp minus sdt. So if you write in terms of partial molar this one, so this also in the same way can be written. Okay, so this you should practice. So these two expressions are very important, 10.18 and 10.19. So that has been used here. So dg bar equal becomes minus si bar dt plus vit. So this is an analogous expression, dg equal to vdp minus sdt, you know, minus sdt plus v. So in the same fashion we have dg. So this fundamental property relation that we learned earlier, dg equal to vdp minus sdt, is similar for partial molar Gibbs energy also. Dg bar equal to, so this is called fundamental partial Gibbs energy relation. So this fundamental Gibbs energy relation and fundamental partial Gibbs energy relation. So this is one of the most important expression. As earlier I told you that the most important equation in this course, you will find that dg equal to vdp minus sdt. So here for the partial molar Gibbs energy also the similar form appears here. Okay, so this may be compared with equation 6.11 that we have learned for pure species, dg equal to vdp minus sdt. Now here it is for the component I which is present in the mixture. So these examples illustrate the parallelism that exists between equations for a constant composition solution that we learned in chapter 6 and the corresponding equations for the partial properties of the species in solution, currently what we are studying. So we can therefore write simply by analogy many equations that relate partial properties, right? Now let us look at the ideal gas state mixture of the model. So far if there is any problem you can ask me. Now what we will learn now, we will apply this concept of partial properties for the ideal gas mixture. So you know, ideal gas and ideal gas mixture both will follow the equation PV equal to nRT. So this, if we apply this equation for ideal gas mixture, now we are taking any solution or mixture, liquid or gas, as a ideal one. So we'll later learn about ideal liquid solutions, but right now we are going to analyze ideal gas mixtures. So here we will apply our equation of state PV equal to nRT. So here it says that despite its limited ability to describe actual mixture behavior, the ideal gas state mixture model provides a conceptual basis upon which to build the structure of solution thermodynamics. So it provides a simple model. So it is useful property model because it has a molecular basis. It approximates reality in the well-defined limit of zero pressure. So you know, when the pressures are almost zero, then the mixtures will behave in ideal fashion, and it is analytically simple. So these are the usefulness of the ideal means. Otherwise, we have many equations of state for non-ideal mixtures. But why do we study ideal gas state? Because it gives a simple mathematical expression for the relationship among pressure, volume, and temperature. So you know what is the ideal gas molecule level. You know, ideal gas represents a collection of molecules that do not interact and occupy, and they occupy no volume. These molecules will have no volume, means this volume is not being considered. This idealization is approached for real molecules in the limit of zero pressure, which implies zero density, because both the energies of intermolecular interactions and the volume fraction occupied by the molecules go to zero with increasing separation of molecules. So this is all theoretical discussions you can learn, means you already know it. So it says that although they do not interact with one another, molecules in the ideal gas state do have internal structure. It differentiates, it is differences in the molecular structure that give rise to differences in ideal gas state heat capacities, enthalpies, entropies, and other properties. So this is internal structure. They have some structure, means, you know. So that's why there are different enthalpies, entropies, and properties. Otherwise, every gas will have the same kind of these properties, but it is not so, because there are, though we have not considered any molecular interaction and volume of the molecule, but we have the molecules themselves have different internal structures. That's why they have different enthalpies, entropies, and properties. Suppose we compare nitrogen with oxygen, or methane, or any kind of other hydrocarbon. So because the molecules themselves are having different structures, so they will have different thermodynamic these properties. Now, molar volume in the ideal gas state can be written, you know, Vig equal to RT by P. So this is very well known to us, and this we can apply for the expressions that we have already derived. So regardless of the nature of the gas, this can be applied. So whatever gas is there, we can apply this one. So here, see, there is no mention of the property of the gas, which gas we are considering. There is no molecular weight kind of things here. Okay, so thus the for ideal gas state, whether of for pure or mixed gases, the molar volume is the same for given temperature and pressure. So look at this. See, if you take mixture or a pure gas, if you take 1 mole of ideal gas mixture and if you take 1 mole of pure gas, suppose nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen all are mixed, and if you take 1 mole of hydrogen separately, 1 mole of nitrogen, 1 mole of oxygen separately, and you measure the volume, and all are considered ideal gas, you will find that for all gases, for 1 mole of the gas, the volume is same. And if you take 1 mole of mixture of these things, means suppose you take 0.2%, 20% oxygen, 30% nitrogen, and 50% hydrogen, so total 100% making. Now if you take 1 mole of mixture, then also for 1 mole of mixture, the volume will be same. So this is conclusion when one which is different from other properties. You should note it, that the solution property becomes equal to the pure component property, and which is also equal to the partial molar property for the volume only. Volume is the only property which has got this thing for ideal gas. Otherwise, for ideal gases, you will see that these things are different. So for ideal gas, you will see that the molar volume of the ideal gas mixture and partial molar property of any component, and the pure component, partial molar volume of the pure component and the partial molar volume of the component, all these three are equal. Similarly, you will find that partial molar internal energy and partial molar enthalpy also follow the same rule. You will find that they are partial molar properties are equal to pure component properties. In terms, means if you take इंटरनल एनर्जी एंड एंथैल्पी। मोलर गिब्स एनर्जी एंड पार्शियल मोलर एंट्रोपी आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम प्योर कंपोनेंट प्रॉपर्टीज, यू विल सून सी दैट। सो लेट अस डेराइव दिस वन, पार्शियल मोलर वॉल्यूम। सो पार्शियल मोलर वॉल्यूम, इफ यू राइट डेफिनेशन ऑफ पार्शियल मोलर वॉल्यूम ऑफ कंपोनेंट आई इन आइडियल गैस मिक्सचर, सो यू विल राइट इट हियर। सो दिस इज डेवर एन वी जी ओवर डेन, कीपिंग टेम्परेचर प्रेशर एंड ऑल दिस। सो दिस इज सोल्यूशन प्रॉपर्टी, mixture property, gaseous mixture. So this is the definition of partial molar volume. Now if you this Vig replace by RT by P, so you will get this one, and then RT by P being constant, see P is constant, T is constant, and compositions, I mean number of moles other than component I are all constant. So RT by P can be taken out, so this become Dever N over Dever Ni, keeping other moles constant. So what it becomes? Dever N over Dever Ni. So this is whatever change you see. So change in total moles per unit change in component means what? So this will become one, Dever N over Dever Ni. Can you see this? This will become one, Dever N, because N is composed of, see, N is composed of Ni plus sigma Nj Nj. Is component I and other. So this, if you change anything, so here it becomes, so change power, if you differentiate with respect to Ni, you will see that this becomes one. Are you okay with this? Dever N over Dever Ni, keeping other component constants, and if you vary only one, so whatever variation in mole, total mole will be there, it will be equal to the variation in moles of the component I. So this will be, the ratio will become one. So it becomes RT by P. So RT by P is nothing but your Vig. See, RT by P is Vig. So this Vig bar becomes equal to Vig. And you know, this RT by P is also equal to, for a pure component, here Vig stands for this molar volume of component I in pure form. This is the molar volume of the component I in solution form, mixture form. And this is the molar volume of the mixture. So all these three things are RT by P, nothing else. Do you agree with this? So you take your 1 minute and you just derive this one, this expression. So this 10.20 says that partial molar volume of the component I is equal to its pure component volume, molar volume, and which is equal to the molar volume of the gaseous mixture. These three things are equal, and which are equal to RT by P. Can take 1 minute and tell me if there is any problem. Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Work out your, take your tech notebook and just work out, take your 1 minute, and you will see that it is very straightforward. Means partial molar volume for ideal gas. We are talking about only for ideal gas. So this, these results I will put in your mind as an important impressions, important conclusions, what we are discussing today. That we have to take little precaution that volume is a little bit different kind of property, and here the partial volume and total volume and pure component volume all are equal, but this is not applicable for the Gibbs energy and entropy, because for PVT relation we can write, but for enthalpy and entropy and Gibbs energy, we don't have such kind of simple relation. So here we define partial pressure of component I. Suppose we want to define a partial pressure of component I. So how do we define? So partial pressure of component I is, you know this very well, means already you know, partial pressure means mole fraction times total pressure. So this RT by Vig is the total pressure. So Vi into P. So this partial pressure is equal to Yi into P. This also you know very well. So partial, so see, partial molar pressure and partial pressure, both are different. Don't get confused with this. See, partial pressure and here you have a partial pressure. So partial molar volume, this is already written here. So RT by P is your partial molar volume. And if you talk about partial pressure, then partial pressure is mole fraction times total pressure. So there is no nothing a term like partial molar pressure. There is nothing a term like that. So in neither there is a term for partial molar temperature. So partial molar temperature, partial molar pressures are not present. So they don't get confused with this. So partial pressure is a term that we already know. So this partial pressure can be always written. So it says that we define the partial pressure of a species I in ideal gas mixture, which is represented as a small pi, as the pressure that a species I would exert if it alone occupied the molar volume of the mixture. That is the definition, you already know it. So it is the pressure when it exists, when the volume is volume for a pure component and volume for the solution, both are equal. If you allow a pure component to occupy the volume of the total mixture, and whatever pressure it exerts, it will be called its partial pressure. So whenever there is a gaseous mixture, we talk about partial pressures of the component. And you know very well that total pressure P, this total pressure P is made of partial pressure. So P is equal to sigma Pi. Okay. So here, if you write sigma Pi, so this will become sigma Yi. Sigma Yi will become 1. So total pressure is made of sum of partial pressures. Please don't get confused that P equal to sigma Yi into Pi. Never write it like that. P equal to sigma Yi means mole fraction times into partial pressure. No. So because it is not partial molar pressure, it is partial pressure. Are you getting it? So don't try to write this total property as a summability relation. So this will not be summability relation as such as you have written here. This summability relation will not be applicable for partial pressure. Partial pressure, sum of partial pressure itself will become total pressure, because sum of partial molar properties will not become equal to total total solution property. It must be multiplied with the mole fraction. Then it will become molar property of the solution. So just this one, summability. So you cannot write it for pressure. So here, if you write total pressure, M equal to total pressure equal to sigma X will be replaced by Yi into Pi. So that will become wrong. So what you should write? You should write total pressure P is equal to sigma Pi simply. No bar, etc., nothing. So that summability for the pressure is like that. This is the summability for the other thermodynamic properties. Okay, similarly for volume also, total volume is equal to sigma Vi simply. Partial means that is Amagat's law. So total volume is equal to sum of partial volumes, no partial molar volume. Partial volume only. Similarly, total pressure is equal to sum of partial pressures, not the sum of partial molar pressure. Okay. So these things you should distinguish. So, okay. So let me return to that. For ideal gas mixture. So we have this one. So this is regarding volume. So volume will have this release. Now, partial pressure also has been defined here, so take care of writing this one. Now there is a Gibbs theorem, very important theorem. Gibbs theorem, what it says that, so let me read it as such, because the ideal gas state mixture model presumes molecules of zero volume that do not interact the thermodynamic properties other than molar volume of the constituent species are independent of one another, and each species has its own set of private properties. This is the basis of the following statement of Gibbs theorem. So Gibbs theorem is applicable for the ideal gas mixture only, and Gibbs theorem does not apply for the
Gibbs theorem.
I'm telling you, man, is whatever is written here in a bold face character, this is your Gibbs theorem.
Okay,
so Gibbs phase rule, I'm not talking about Gibbs phase rule or Gibbs equation or Gibbs DUM relation. See, Gibbs was the person who contributed most in for the Julia Willard Gibbs. You can read about him on internet. Means this is the man who has contributed lot of chemical engineering thermodynamics. So there are Gibbs phase rule, there is a Gibbs DUM relation, there is a Gibbs theorem, all are different. So here now Gibbs theorem says about relationship of the partial molar property and the pure component property. So this Gibbs theorem, what it does, it is first thing you should note that Gibbs theorem always applies for the ideal gas mixture, and it says that that it is just a theorem given as a statement. There is no proof given as such. So I am reading it. So first thing, that Gibbs theorem you should not apply for the volume. Volume is exception. Okay, so let me read it first, then I will explain it. A partial molar property. So this, a partial molar property means a property of the component inside the mixture. It says other than volume, means you should not consider this partial molar property is the exception, means leave it, means don't consider volume. What you should consider, you can consider enthalpy, you can consider Gibbs energy, you can take entropy. So internal energy, enthalpy, Gibbs energy, and entropy, means you can take UHS, internal energy, enthalpy, and Gibbs energy. Okay, UHGS means you take U internal energy, H enthalpy, G Gibbs energy, and S entropy. These four properties mainly you have to consider. Leave the volume, please don't consider volume, because volume has this relation, it will not be applicable. Means volume has got a special relationship, this one. Otherwise, if you apply this Gibbs theorem for the volume also, this will be false. So this does not follow. Means, see, this partial property is becoming equal to the pure component property, and which is equal to more solution property also. So volume. So this is means against the Gibbs theorem, which I am going to state here. So just note it. What very interesting. A partial molar property, take the exception of the volume, of a constituent species means the species which is making the solution, a mixture, in an ideal gas state mixture. Ideal gas state mixture, you know, this is ideal gas state has been written together. So it is a particular state where we consider an ideal gas model to be applicable. So any gas can behave as an ideal gas when it is taken at a very low pressure, and if there is a mixture of many ideal gases, then it can most probably behave as ideal gas mixture. And if you take ideal gases, individual ideal gases, and you mix them, but if you change some their temperature pressure, then they can behave non-ideal gas mixture. So what the simplification we have taken, we have considered a pure component gases as ideal gases, and there if we mix those gases, then we have considered here, I mean, imagined that they are making mixture as an ideal gas. So that also means mixture also behaves as an ideal gas. So here let me read it. A partial molar property with the exception of volume of a constituent species in an ideal gas state mixture is equal. See, this partial molar property is equal to the corresponding molar property of the species. See, this partial molar property and molar property both are becoming equal. But that is not the complete statement. Now let us see what it says of the species in the pure ideal gases. So the component is taken as a pure, it is away from the solution, pure ideal gas state at the mixture temperature and at a pressure equal to its partial pressure in the mixture. Just read it yourself once. Take your time. Read it yourself. Let me ask somebody to read it. Okay. Rashi, please, can you read it? Read this one, Gibbs theorem. Loudly you can read. Rashi, what happened? My voice is not reaching. Hello?
Your voice is clear.
Your voice is reaching.
So Rashi is not responding. What happened? Anyone can read it. Anushka, please, can you read this loudly statement of the Gibbs theorem?
Yes, sir.
Please.
A partial molar property other than volume of a constituent species in an ideal gas mixture is equal to the corresponding molar property of the species as a pure ideal gas at the mixture temperature but at a pressure equal to its partial pressure in this.
So it seems a complicated statement. Do you understand what it says? It's a very simple thing to understand. You have number of gases which are in fact in pure state. You have oxygen, nitrogen, helium, neon, methane, ethane, propane, whatever gas you consider, they are all in pure state, suppose. Okay, and you take one mole gas of everyone, one mole of gas, and they are contained in a different cylinders. They are in pure state and they have certain temperature T, and they have certain pressure which is P. Now what you do, you connect all these cylinders with each other and make a mixture of the gases. Now this total pressure of this mixture will be equal to the bring it to the same temperature and pressure. Whatever gases you have taken, temperature and pressure, you have a mixture of the gases at the same temperature and pressure. But you know, when you calculate the partial pressure of a particular gas inside the mixture, you always know that it is mole fraction times the total pressure. So if you have suppose nitrogen and oxygen, if you mix them in 40-60 ratio and you make a total pressure 1 atmospheric pressure, so what is the partial pressure of nitrogen in the mixture? Suppose you have 40% nitrogen and 60% nitrogen and 40% oxygen, and you earlier had this suppose you had nitrogen at 1 atmospheric pressure, oxygen also 1 atmospheric pressure, but when you make a mixture, you again make a total pressure 1 atmospheric pressure. Now the you have such a mixture in which there is a 60% mole percent of the nitrogen and 40 mole percent of oxygen. So I am asking, what is the partial pressure of the nitrogen in the mixture? What is the partial pressure of oxygen in the mixture? Please tell me. Total pressure of the mixture is 1 atmospheric pressure. So what is the partial pressure of nitrogen inside the mixture? Answer. So partial pressure is equal to mole fraction times into total pressure. So what is the mole fraction? So I already told you that 60% nitrogen. So mole fraction is 0.6. And oxygen, what is the mole fraction?
40%.
0.4. 40%. So when we say fraction, so this value should be less than 1. So we are taking total value 1. So mole fraction means 1 mole. So out of 1 mole, 0.6 mole is of nitrogen and 0.4 mole is of oxygen. So what is the partial pressure of nitrogen? So mole fraction times total pressure. So this become 0.6 atmospheric pressure. And for oxygen, it becomes 0.4 atmospheric pressure. So sum of this partial pressure should make total pressure. You know, this is a your Dalton's law. Huh? Sum of partial pressure will make the total pressure. So 0.6 plus 0.4 will make 1 atmospheric pressure. So this is the that much simple. So so that means the mixture which is there at some temperature T, suppose 25 degrees Celsius, and 1 atmospheric pressure, some pressure P. So it will have different partial pressures of the component. It will have different partial pressures of the components as per their amount, how much amount is present there. So this total pressure will get distributed according to the amount of the component present in the mixture. So that it says that if you take that property, so now if inside the gaseous mixture you consider a property of any component, which will be the partial molar property of that component. Now it will be equal to its pure component property when the gas was in pure state, particular oxygen or nitrogen. So suppose we talk about partial molar property of nitrogen, it is equal to the its pure state nitrogen property, pure state gas property. So we talk about, suppose, Gibbs energy of 1 mole of the nitrogen present in the mixture will be equal to the Gibbs energy of the nitrogen when it is present in the pure state. Both are equal, then what is the fun? What is the interesting thing? When both are equal, then why we are so much interested? But the condition is that you take that particular pure state gas, nitrogen gas, not at 1 atmospheric pressure, but you take that pure state gas at a partial pressure which is present in the mixture state. So in pure state form, you have to compare with its partial pressure, not the pressure of the mixture itself. Do you understand this one? So this is a statement here. So you see, this is the expression mathematically. So this MIG bar is not equal to VIG bar. So you have to take the exception this one. And see, partial molar property of the component I present in the gaseous mixture at temperature and pressure. So this is a mixture state, solution state, where the temperature is T, pressure is P. So this T and P are the temperature of the gaseous mixture, and pressure is the pressure of the gaseous mixture. It is not the pressure of the component I which is present in the mixture. What is the pressure of the component I which is present in the mixture? It is its partial pressure, this PI. So this component I which is present in the gaseous mixture, and the gaseous mixture is at temperature T and pressure P. So this partial molar property of that component will be equal to its pure component property. So this represents pure, PMIIG, because bar is not here. So this is the component I which is present in pure state at the solution temperature or the mixture temperature. These two temperatures are same, T and T. But this pure component gas is present now only at a partial pressure which is present inside the mixture. This partial pressure, you have means you keep this component I in pure state only at its only at a pressure equal to the partial pressure of the component in the mixture. Now is that clear? Left hand side is about mixture, right hand side is about pure component. So only thing difference is this P, which is total pressure of the mixture, and here PI, it is a partial pressure. So if it is present in the pure state, there is no meaning of partial pressure, but you whatever pressure you keep in pure state, it is equal to the partial pressure of that component which was there present in the mixture. So any property will, so this is Gibbs theorem. So this you should remember always. Now with this definition, with this means assumption to be true, we can write it for internal energy, we can write it for enthalpy, we can write it for Gibbs energy, and we can write it for entropy. So just look at quickly here, because this suppose we take enthalpy, we can write for enthalpy also. So we have taken this M equal to H. Now enthalpy, partial molar enthalpy, it will become equal to HIG, because why? This enthalpy is for the pure state, pure gas, is not a function of pressure. You know, internal energy and enthalpy, both are not dependent on the pressure for the ideal gas. You know it. So ideal gas is, see, this HIG bar TP equal to this is due to the Gibbs theorem. Now this PI, we have replaced it with P, because this HIG will not depend on P. So it again becomes equal to P, means you take PI or P, both are same thing. So we have taken this one. So HIG bar T at temperature T and P, conditions T and P, is equal to pure component enthalpy at T and P. So both become equal. So partial molar enthalpy is equal to pure component enthalpy, same temperature and pressure. This is at T and P, this is also T and P. So whether you keep it in pure state at the same temperature and pressure, or whether you keep it in the mixture, So mixture temperature and pressure, T and P, same. So whatever temperature pressure is in pure state, same temperature and pressure is of the gaseous mixture. So enthalpies will be same, partial molar enthalpy and pure component enthalpy. Similarly, for internal energy also, you can write UIG bar equal to UIG. This is also same. See, analogous equation applies to UIG. So enthalpy and internal energy. So now what we look that the partial molar enthalpy and partial molar internal energies are equal to the pure component enthalpy and pure component internal energy. Now for the entropy, because it is dependent on the pressure, we can write, so ds equal to minus rd ln p constant at constant temperature. So entropy is an ideal gas, does depend on pressure. So 6.24 expression restricted to constant temperature can be written like this. 6.24. Can you look at the 6.24? What is the 6.24? So look at this quickly. So this is ds equal to Cp dT by T minus R dP by P. 6.24. 6.24 says ds equal to Cp ideal gas dT by T minus R dP by P. Look at your text. So if you consider at constant temperature, because in both cases temperature is constant, so if you keep temperature constant, so dT will become zero. So it becomes ds Ig equal to minus R dP by P. Minus R dP by P can be written as d ln P. So this is like this. So it is a change of entropy due to change in temperature and pressure. And if you write it for constant temperature, because the temperature of the mixture and temperature of the pure component, both are same. So if there is any change is not happening in temperature, so this can be written. Now this provides the basis for computing the entropy difference between a gas at its partial pressure in the mixture and at total pressure of the mixture. So now if you integrate it, so this becomes d at temperature and pressure minus, so what we you have into in, if you put at integration sign, then you are changing, what you are doing, you are taking the gas from pure state partial pressure to the mixture partial, means temperature is constant but only pressure is being changed, means from the partial pressure PI you are going to the total pressure P. So if you integrate it, you can write like this, and right hand term you can write R ln P by PI. So this P changes from PI to P. So this you can write. So this become minus R ln P over YI into P. So this PI is equal to YI into P. So PP gets cancelled, R ln Y. So this is your very important expression. Means you have transferred a pure gas which was there at temperature T and partial pressure Pi to a mixture state which is at temperature T and total pressure P of the mixture. So here this you can write. So this is your pure component and this is your, so this you can write minus R ln. So this is means this is simply this integration is in fact 1 minute, let me correct myself. This expression is change of pressure for a pure component, guys. This is not going in the mixture. Okay, so remember, because this integration has happened only for, there is no bar sign here. So this a gas is being taken from partial pressure Pi to a total pressure P, a pure gas. So what is the change in entropy? So due to the, this is in fact, this is a change of entropy due to the change in the pressure. So what is the change in pressure? Pi to P, pure gas, both are pure gas. So this will be equal to R ln Yi. So this is there. See, pure component gas at temperature T and partial pressure is equal to this total, means temperature and pressure, whatever is there, minus R ln Yi. So this Yi will become there when it is a fraction inside the mixture. So comparing this equation with entropy, written for entropy means you can write it here. Please see if you write it for the partial molar entropy. So if it is taken in the mixture, see partial molar entropy inside the mixture and T and P becomes equal to Sig T and P minus R ln Y. So this can be written from the same expression. So if you compare this one, so this is a change of the entropy of pure component when it goes to the mixture state. So this is your Sig mixture state. This is pure component property minus R ln Y. So this expression is very important. You will apply this for calculation of the change in entropy due to the mixing. Means if any gas is taken from pure state to the mixture state, what is the entropy change at the same temperature and pressure? No temperature pressure change happens, only it is changes its state from pure to mixture state. Okay, similarly for Gibbs energy you can write. So for Gibbs energy you can write this expression and then you again calculate this one. So changes of enthalpy for the mixing for ideal gases are nil. There is no change, only Gibbs energy changes and entropy changes will be there. You will see that changes in the enthalpy and internal energy due to mixing are nil, zero. Okay, so we will see that. So we'll take this topic further. Right now let me close because time is running out. So I am stopping the presentation and quickly taking the attendance.